Welcome back to Studio 10. Rebecca Gibney is one of Australia's most loved actresses. She's played a variety of dramatic roles throughout the years, but none of those compared to the real-life drama which took place in her very own home. Rebecca's sister Stella fell pregnant and had to make the heartbreaking decision to give up her child when she was only 14 years old. And there is more to this story. To tell us about it, please welcome Stella Gibney to Studio 10. You had this incredible story bottled up inside of you for many, many years. Mm-hmm. You put it into a personal diary, but it was actually your sister, Rebecca, who encouraged you.
She did.
To write it, to put it into a book.
To write the memoir, yeah.
Was it a hard thing to do?
It was at the time. It took me 9 months, but because I had my journals to reflect on, I was able to, call on those memories, so, yeah.
14 is very young to fall pregnant. Mm. Can you talk to us about the circumstances leading up to that?
The guy that I fell pregnant to, he was living in the house, and I used to sneak into his bedroom at night time, just to be held, really. I just wanted to be held, and
he was your brother's friend?
My brother's friend, yeah. And I fell pregnant.
How old was he?
He was 18.
So when you fell pregnant, obviously there was no question of marriage.
No. My father wanted me to have an abortion. I didn't believe in abortion. I didn't want to have an abortion. But in those days you had to go before a team of doctors who would decide for you. And, they decided for me. And I'm grateful that they did because I have my son.
But is it true you weren't even allowed to hold your baby, who you called Christopher?
Yes.
You weren't allowed to hold the baby?
No. In those days, when you had a child up for adoption, you weren't allowed to see them. So the nurse was about to pass Christopher to me, and the matron came in and said, the child's to be adopted, she's not to see him. So they took Christopher from me, and then the next day they were short-staffed, so they asked me if I could feed him. So, which was a difficult thing to do because it was very heart-wrenching to give him back after that time. So.
You were only a child yourself.
I was.
When you had your son. Yeah. And after all those years, you never stopped thinking about him?
Never, no. Every birthday I cried. Every 2nd of August of every year I cried. And on his 18th birthday, I wrote him a letter. And it was a very heart-wrenching letter. Just describing the circumstances of how I fell pregnant, why I chose to give him up for adoption. I was only 14 and I couldn't offer him a home. And in the 1970s, there was no such thing as IVF. It was just and there was a lot of people that wanted to have children. I said, I'd give you up for adoption. Could you please forgive me?
Well, it took 22 years, but Stella was finally reunited with her son. We're going to speak to him after this very short break. You're watching Studio 10. Welcome back to Studio 10. Well, just before the break, we met the gorgeous Stella Gibney, the sister of actress Rebecca Gibney. And Stella shared her story of giving up her child for adoption when she fell pregnant at the age of 14. And right now, her son, Corey, joins us live from New Zealand. Good morning, Corey.
Yeah, good morning. How are you?
Well, your birth mother's eyes just lit up when she saw you on the screen. This, of course, isn't the first time you guys have met, but it did take you 22 years to find each other. Do you remember what that day was like when you first met?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, it was so surreal. We'd spent so many hours on the phone talking prior, and it just was so natural. Just walking out the airport and big hugs and tears, and it was an incredible day. Still sticks with me vividly today. As do every other memory that we have together. It's great.
Did you always know you were adopted, Corey?
I did. It would have been about 9 or 10, I think we were told. And at that sort of age, it was a little bit hard to comprehend exactly what it was all about. But it did make some sense why my adoptive father was 6 foot tall and built rather large. Played lock for Wellington. So I was wondering why I missed out on those genes, I suppose you'd say. you know, meeting Stella was just, and my half-brothers has just, yeah, completed who I feel I am. So, yes, that's amazing.
What are your memories of the day, Stella, when you first laid eyes on your son?
Oh, one of the most memorable days of my life. I had a rose. I took it to the airport and I just waited. I wasn't sure what he looked like. I just had this rose and I just was praying, God, just show me the right person. And he walked out and there was just no doubt in my mind.
Do you find things about each other now that you share in common?
Oh, absolutely. Right. We're so much alike, aren't we?
Oh, indeed, yeah.
In what way? Come on, are you argumentative? Are you easy to get along with?
We're
Do you have a quirky sense of humour?
Very passionate people. Corey started his own business, as I started my own business, so entrepreneurial. He's a fun-loving guy.
Corey, your adoptive mother has been very, very good to you, I believe, during this whole process and has been quite supportive in you finding your birth mother.
Absolutely. As hard as it would have been for her, as it has been, she supported me the whole way through. Both my adoptive mother and Stella have both been through, you know, turmoils over the years. It's been incredible that she's been so supportive and still is.
And you actually call Stella mum now, don't you?
I do, yeah. Yeah.
It's just Stella natural. Stella and Corey, what's your relationship like now?
It's really very close. Like? Yeah.
Oh, very close, it is. Whenever I go over there to visit, it's like we both stay, it just feels like yesterday I've left. It's just everything so natural. Yeah, it's amazing. Yeah.
Are you married? Do you have children?
Yes, I do. Yep.
So
yep.
You're a grandmother.
So, yes, and she is.
Well, just before, sorry, go on, Corey.
She's a grandmother to a little daughter of mine, Abby, who's 12, and Dylan, who's 18.
Oh, it's a beautiful end to a story, a story that started out with so much pain. We touched on it just before the break, but your sister, your very famous sister, Rebecca Gibney, actually she encouraged you to write this down and put your thoughts in a book.
Yeah, she did. I was staying with her one day up in Whale Beach. It was only 18 months ago. And she asked me, what were you doing? And I said, you know, I was just journaling. She said, why don't you write it all down this in a book? And
has it been cathartic?
Very, very. It was an emotional journey, but very cathartic.
But it helps, doesn't it? It puts it all in perspective when you look back and think about all the things that happened to you.
Absolutely.
And Stella's book is out now. You can pick it up from all good bookstores. Thank you very much, Stella, for joining us as well. Corey, there in New Zealand. I can just tell you just want to reach through the camera lens and give him a big hug. Sorry about that. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.